Hello everybody, Bill and Charles here from QA1. Let's say you're thinking about doing some suspension upgrades, but you don't necessarily know where to start. We're gonna roadmap it for you. Scenario is maybe you just bought yourself a muscle car, it's bone stock and you don't want it to handle and drive like an old bone stock muscle car. What would you say would be kind of step number one for improving?
One of the first things that you're going to be able to feel right away is shocks. And it all depends on whether or not if you're thinking about lowering your car a little bit or changing your ride height some, we have our Stocker Star shocks that are going to be a direct bolt in, but then they're adjustable. And then you can change on how it rides, whether it's firmer or softer, and you basically are going to make a great improvement that you're gonna feel right away.
Yep. And if you do wanna change ride height,
then you can go with our Pro Coil, which then you have multiple spring rates to choose, and you also have the adjustable ride height via the shock.
So the shocks themselves are the same between a non-threaded body and a threaded body. It's just whether or not they're ride height adjustable.
Yep, and this one allows you to adjust a ride height with multiple spring rates.
And that is, if you're going to continue on the upgrading path, the coilovers are forward compatible with later parts that we'll get into next.
These will work with the factory, lower control arms, and they also work with our tubular control arms.
Okay, so now you've done shocks, you've gotten that out of the way. The next thing is what?
Probably the next level up is a sway bar, especially if your car doesn't have a sway bar already. I mean, that's going to make a huge improvement on the amount that your car leans in and out of the corners. And there was a lot of the factory ones that, even though it had a factory sway bar, they were pretty tiny and they didn't really offer a lot of sway control. And with our tubular sway bars, they definitely will make that, your car stay a lot more level and planted through the corners.
Yeah, and you'll notice it. They're a really easy install. They just replace the factory.
They bolt up basically in the exact same as the factory ones would have, and they use a lot of hardware that's all very similar to the factory sway bars too.
And they will work with backwards compatible with factory pieces.
Oh yes, yep.
So you can do a set of sway bars without having to always have everything else to support it.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, I mean, you could bolt in just one of our sway bars if you wanted to and not have any of our other components.
You've got this 500 horsepower engine and all it does is roast tires or give you a violent wheel hop, so what would you do for that?
Well, one of the best things you could do is just take those old, rusty, worn out rear trailing arms and throw them right in the scrap pile. Because, one, those rubber bushings are super soft, they're all cracked up, they're not helping your suspension one bit.
They never got replaced, even when those cars were like regular daily
nobody's
driver.
Ever replaced their, why would you do that? and then you also have these stamped steel housings that there's a lot of flex there.
And
that
flex, twist.
Yeah, and that flex is detrimental to your, to traction.
That's loss of control.
Oh yes, exactly. And so with tubular style trailing arms, you have polyurethane bushings, which, eliminate all that flex. And then plus the tubular steel eliminates all of that flex as well.
And they're freshly painted, so you don't have to put rusty junk back on or, spend all your time sandblasting and painting and all that stuff.
And we also have upper trailing arms that are adjustable for those guys that want to lower the ride height a bunch and then get all that, get their drive line and everything all tuned back in.
Okay, so we've done shocks, coilovers, sway bars, trailing arms, and up to this point we haven't done anything to change any geometry specs.
Your factory, control arms in the front of the car are, only allow so much, change in your alignment.
So we've maximized what our tire contact patch can do with the factory alignment specs up till this point.
Yeah.
Well, now we want to address the actual front end alignment of the car and the geometry of that. And you'll hear geometry. What that really means is you know, what are the alignment specs that you can expect to achieve? Factory stuff was really low. It was, you know, 0 to 3 degrees of caster, which, you know, think about caster like a caster wheel on a shopping cart. If you get one that's in positive caster, that's where you get the wobbly wheel that drives you nuts.
Oh yeah, and the car just wants to kind of just slowly wander all over the road. The less caster you have, the more it has a tendency to do that.
Yeah. So what does a set of tubular control arms do for you?
Well, one of the biggest things it's going to do is it's going to, you know, you're going to totally change up your front suspension geometry so that it's more suited to modern day, like, radial tires and, you know, wider tires. And then, because what it's going to do is it's going to give you more negative camber, which keeps your tire's contact patch in the corners, you know, keeps it flatter, gives you more traction. And then it's also going to increase your caster, which is going to give you more of that straight line stability. And then it's also going to help with your turn in, you know, your traction on the, you know, your turn in on turns. It's going to keep those tires planted.
You're going to better feedback through the steering wheel.
Oh yeah,
it's not
going to
feel
definitely,
nearly, yeah. You know, the old cars were really vague in the steering
oh, yeah.
wheel. So you get some, you know, 5 to 7 degrees of caster in there. And now all of a sudden you go into a corner and you can feel it.
You're going to have much more road feel. You're going to be able to basically feel that point when your tires actually start to lose grip a lot of times, and you're going to be able to compensate for that, and you're going to be able to push your car even harder through the turns than what you ever could before.
So everything up till the point of control arms is essentially maximizing your tire performance with the factory alignment specs. You go to a set of control arms, well, now you're changing your tire contact patch area essentially. And you're making it, now you're raising the bar.
Yeah, I mean, you're making the contact patch more, you know, flatter with the road at all points of the suspension travel, and it's allowing, you know, your tires to maintain traction. It's keeping your tires from rolling over and breaking that traction loose and letting the car slide.
So this stuff is all direct bolt-on stuff. You can do it on jack stands in your garage, and everything from the very beginning stages is compatible with everything through the very end, so you're not having to double up on parts that you've already bought. If you have any questions, you can get a hold of us on the tech lines. Check out our website. We've got a lot of great tech articles that go a little bit more in depth in some of these components and what they're actually doing, and go drive it.